guess I'm going to walk. Oh, that milky white way. Oh, child, some of these days. Well, I'm going to walk that milky white way. Oh, some of these days. Well, 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 I'm going to walk up and take up my stand. Gonna join that Christian band. I'm going to walk, whoa, that milky white way. Oh, Lord, some of these days. I'm gonna tell my, oh, my mother, howdy, 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 when I get home. Yes, I'm going to tell my mother, howdy, when I get home. Well, 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 I want to tell my mother, hey, when I shake mother hand that day, that's when I walk, oh, that milky white way, some of these days. I want to meet God the Father.
The eternal God is your refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. For I know that my redeemer lives, that I look my skin is destroyed. Yes, I know that in my flesh I shall survive. The Lord is my shepherd.
Power to the weak and to those. Thank you. Lord, Ah! getting ready to go to church and worship the God that I had preached and taught about for over four decades. I called my mentor, Pastor Rudolph Allen, and these are the words he said to me. Thad, nobody will feel badly if you don't preach this morning. But if at all possible, you go and you preach what you've been telling other folks when they were in your place, that God is able. Nobody's going to look at you differently if you choose not to stand today. But now, son, the rubber meets the road. And let me say to this family, my family, weep not as those who have no hope. But understand and know that our beloved sister is with the Lord. May we pray. Eternal ruler and super ruler of both heaven and earth, precious in your sight is the death of your saints. Father, in the name of Jesus, the Christ, the living Lord, I intercede on behalf of this bereaved family, my family. They are bereft of a loved one who left. Sophia has left the limitations placed on her because of flesh and finitude. Sophia has left this earthly tabernacle, this temporal tent, in which for over four decades she persevered pain, yet she continued to push. P-U-S-H, Lord, she pushed. She prayed until something happened. And on the other day, something did happen. You stopped by a hospital room in Atlanta, Georgia, with TJ by her side. He'd been there for 16 years, Lord, but on this particular day, you called Sophia from labor to reward. She exchanged pain for peace and persecution for your presence. She traded her cross for her crown. Sophia was finally done with the troubles of this old world. She heard the first and the last, the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, who is and who was and who is to come. The Almighty, Eternal God say, servant of God, well done. Rest from thy love employ. The battle is fought, the victory won. Enter thy master's joy. The pains of death are past, labor and sorrow cease, and life's long warfare closed at last. Her soul is found in peace. Soldier of Christ, well done. Praise be thy new employ, and while eternal ages run, rest in thy Savior's joy. Master, please strengthen TJ and the children, Jeanette and her siblings, uncles and aunties, cousins and classmates. May we all find blessed assurance in your word, your servant's prayer. Amen.
I'm worrying, worrying how the story ends. I let go and I let God. I let God have his way. That's when things start happening. And I stop looking at back then. I let go and I let God. I let God have his way. I couldn't seem to fall asleep. There was so much on my mind. I was searching for that peace, but no peace I could not find. That's when I kneeled down to pray, God help me please. And he said, you don't have to cry, 'cause I'll supply all your needs. Soon as I stopped worrying how the story, I let go and I let God, I let God have his way. That's when things start happening. And I stop looking at back then. I let go and I let God, I let God have his way. There was so much going on. Sometimes I can't find my way. And oftentimes I struggle from day to day. I had to realize that it's not my battle. It's not my battle to fight. I had to know that if I put it in the hands, that everything will be all right. Soon as I stop worrying how the story ends, I let go and I let God, have his way. That's when things start happening. And I stop looking at back then. I let go and I let God. I let God have his way. So let go and let God. Let go and let God. Just let go. And let God, just let go. And let God, oh, let go. And let God, he's the only one with the answers. Oh, let God, he can handle it all, yes he can. Oh, let God, oh, let go. You gotta let go and let God. Soon as I stop worrying how the story ends, I let go and I let God. I let God have his way. That's when things start happening. And I stop looking at back then. And I let go and I let God. I let God have his way.
Book of Isaiah, chapter 65, verses 17 through 18. should I be remembered? Lord, come into mind. But be ye glad and rejoice forever in that which I create. For behold, I will create Jerusalem a rejoicing, and her people a joy. And I will rejoice in Jerusalem, and in the joy, and joy in my people. And the voice of weeping shall be no more heard in heart, nor the voice of crying.
Thank you. It's just not out there. See, wisdom sometimes can be puffed up. let me talk about, I talk to some people, and I always talk to people that prepare my eulogy. I talked with her husband, and he said, she would do anything for me. And I did anything for her.
Well,
so I'm all right.
Yeah.
And she was that kind of person.
Right.
If she could, she would do it.
Yeah.
And after her death, it kind of coming out from everywhere. All of the stuff that she did.
Yes.
I thought about me, I thought about me for many, many years. Many, many years I would tell her sometimes she'd call me. I said, can you stop laughing like that? Let your husband sit right there. But she would call me. And we would just laugh and laugh. I know the internet at the church goes sometimes in the community. It's been a while back. And Sophia calls me and asked me about the internet. And one day she asked me, what is your business about our internet? She said, ain't no shame in my game. If it's off, I can't do what I need to do. And if she would hear something about me, folk like to talk about me, right? Sophia would call me and ask me, now what I hear, I want you to tell me the truth. On my last yesterday, for everybody who don't know, I was in the paper. They had me with a mug shot. They said I stole somebody. I was not crying. But anyway, Sophia called to me and said, well, I told him all my brother that did that. He might have done the most stuff. But he didn't do that. But she always left me with something. I said, Sophia, why? Well, no, we're not to talk about me. She said, because you're somebody. The people don't talk about you. But then when everything died down and got settled, Reverend, Sophia said, you done lost your touch. I have not heard anything from me, but she would leave me with a peace. She would leave me with something I might have been down in the spirit, but when she left me, I was feeling okay. Mm-hmm. I talked to Reverend Lewis. Reverend Lewis said, she got all my stuff on the job drive. She helped me with my everything. I talked to her mother. Her mother said, I would be talking about I need to do this and this and this and this. And the next thing I know, it was done. I'm that's wisdom, y'all.
Yeah.
She showed me how I could just do stuff from right here where I'm at. She said she made my other children do what I said, do. She got things done. That's wisdom, y'all. I talked to Dr. Bryan. Dr. Bryan said she ran our company. That she did everything. We did not do nothing because of her wisdom. To be organized, that must be some wisdom. To get things going, that must be some wisdom. To move in all of those directions, that must be some wisdom. So whoever named their well,
right?
Wisdom. Now let me help you. Sophia left us unexpected. It was an unexpected death, young woman. See, we look for people of age to be with. But when a young person, 40 years old, leaves us, it does something to us.
Yeah.
But can I just tell you today that life is filled with many unexpected things?
Amen.
We need to understand that. Perhaps we are never more aware of the fact that when we are faced with death, see, we view death as a curse, even as an enemy. Death always catches us unprepared. And today is such an occasion. somebody died at an age, a young age, is so unexpected. And we face with some troublesome questions. And we got some feelings, I got some feelings. Grief tends to make us turn inward with questions. And we ask the question, how did they die? Why we thank God is natural and prove itself. The question is, we should ask, how did the person live? It matters more how you live than how you die. It matters more than the birthday and the death date, but what really matters is that dash in between. How a person died is not nearly as important as how they live.
Right.
And we ask ourselves and others, why has this thing happened? It is obvious that no one can give a satisfactory answer because no one knows. Somebody said, well, Pastor, what we need to do? See, when death comes suddenly, our pain, it causes us pain and it changes our plans and it moves all the things around and we ask the question, why did this happen? But whatever you are feeling today, let me encourage you to take it to God. Take it to God. God is big enough to handle your pain. God is big enough. Somebody mad. When my mama was taken, I got mad with God. And God straightened me out. He said, she would die 8 years ago. And you said, give her a little more time. I think 8 years a lot more time. So if you're angry, but take it to God. And God can help you with that. The only thing that God can't help you with is if you don't take it to him. If you refuse to take it to God, then God cannot help you. And we always hear the statement, what a tragedy. But while death is a troublesome, it needs not to be a tragedy. Death is coming. It's inevitable for all of us. And the only way that it is a tragedy is that you are unprepared. See, the truth is that each of us in turn will meet death. We don't know when, and we don't know where, but we know we will.
Amen.
And what can we do? We can have faith in God. And how can we make sure that our death is triumphant? I'm going to tell you how you make sure today. See, we're confused sometimes over the mysteries of life. We can accept the mysteries of physical things. We can accept that a big battleship made out of all that steel can sail on water. We can accept how a huge plane that weighs 20 tons can fly in the air. We can accept how a computer in seconds can calculate what I can't in a lifetime. We can accept how far our words travel on fiber optic. We can accept how the picture from the satellite is beamed into my television. I don't know how these things happen, but I accept them. But we avoid the mysteries of the spiritual realm. While we accept the things that we cannot understand in the physical world around us, we are often disturbed and distressed by the things we cannot understand in the spiritual world. By many things that we cannot understand about life. Why is it that one is taken and another one is left? Why is a good person taken and a bad person left to live? Why is a 95-year-old person live and a 40-year-old person die? That's a question that I can't answer. But when there are no answers, in time, faith. There is a thing we cannot understand, but we can trust God. When we do not understand where there is confusion in our mysteries of life, we must commit ourselves to the word of God.
Yes.
That's where
Amen.
I go.
Amen.
But I don't understand.
Amen.
You might be saying, I think it's great about this thing, but what am I saying to that? You go to the book.
Amen.
I used to, in my old days, to the book, but it's the iPad, it's the telephone. There's a whole lot of things. But you go and you read the word of God.
Yes.
And the Bible is now and has been and always will be the information to attain assurance. The Bible tells us that it is appointed unto man once to die, but yet it's still the Bible always also tells us that Jesus said, I'll never leave you nor will I forsake you. Yes. The Bible tells us that he loves us, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, yes, but have everlasting life.
Amen.
The Bible tells me that one of these old bones.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So I look to the word of God.
Yeah.
I say to you today, look unto Jesus.
Yeah.
If you keep on praying, then he's going to make me pray. Look unto the word of God.
Yeah.
I look to him.
Yeah.
When I can't look nowhere,
yeah,
I look, David say, I look, I'm down here looking toward the hill. From whence coming all of my help? I want you to know today. Look toward the hill. How you going to miss Sophia? I'm going to miss Sophia. But look toward the hill. Sometimes you're going to laugh about it. But look toward the hill.
Wait.
There are many words that we can use to describe you. But there's one word that stands in our hearts and in our minds today. And that word is special. You were special in so many ways. You were special because you had a way of making sure that everything that we did was done a certain way. You were special because you took time enough to love hard and to make sure that whenever we walked away from you, we knew that we were loved. You were special because you picked up the phone and you called us at those times when things were not going well. You were special because your laughter could be heard throughout the house. But you were special because of your smile. When you smiled, everything that was wrong seemingly was made right. To the world, they may never know you, but to us, you are the world. The world may wonder who you are, but to us, we know you. We know you because you held our hands when things were not going well. You wiped tears from our eyes when we thought we would never stop crying. But you were special because you helped us along the way. And now that you've gone away from us, you're still all the more special to us. They tell us that heaven is a prepared place, prepared for special people. So we know that in heaven, you have a special place. And in our hearts, you will forever be special. Because Sophia, there's only one, and you will forever be special to us. The family of Sophia Latrice Smith Sutton wishes to express their most sincere and heartfelt appreciation to each of you for the many kind and loving gestures of sympathy that have been extended during this time of sorrow. It is our prayer that you will continue to pray for this family in the days to come, realizing and knowing that there is a void that is left. But we realize and we know that God has a way of healing all voids. So pray that as we look to him in the days to come, that we gain strength and we are comforted. We thank you for everything that you have done, every prayer that has been prayed, and every word of encouragement that has been shared. We thank you. We thank you. At this time, we wish to acknowledge four offering and resolutions that have been sent. Whole Truth International, Pastor George F. Munch, Jr., resolution for Sister Sophia S. Sutton. Whereas it has pleased the Almighty God to take unto himself our sister, too soon by our measure, but in the providence of an all-knowing and divine God. Whereas not only is this a loss of a devoted daughter, sister, wife, mother, and aunt, but also a confident counselor and closest of friends, a person who was always available to share an encouraging word and to demonstrate strong support to those in need. Therefore, we resolve that we vow acceptance of the perfection of God's plan to gather each of us into his merciful arms. Be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution be given to the family and a copy kept in the church archives. Respectfully submitted on the 6th day of November in the year of our Lord 2021 on behalf of the officers and members of Whole Truth International Memories Missionary Ministries Incorporated, Americus, Georgia, Reverend George F. Munch, Jr., Overseer, Senior Pastor. Your friends at Council Service, may you rest in peace, our friend Sophia, from your friends from SGTC, Laquanda, Allegra, and Stephen, with deepest sympathy, the Bible High School class of 1981. With deepest sympathy, your Marlin Logistics family, Wilmer and Barbara. With deepest sympathy, Brother Tyler and family. With love and sympathy, Mr. and Mrs. Leroy Reynolds and family. The family flower is given in loving memory of a loving, faithful, and caring wife, mother, daughter, sister, aunt, aunt, niece, cousin, and friend from the family. Beloved memory of Dr. Napoleon Williams, Deacon Arthur Parker, CEO and President, along with the staff of the J.W. Williams Funeral Home, presents to this family, African American family, Heirloom Bible. It is our prayer that you know in the days to come that there will be answers. But no matter what the questions are, the answers are found in the Word of God. And that's the only true answer that you need. We're also pleased to present to this family a pictorial tribute of Sophia's life. What a life. What a time and what a time to remember. And finally, we present to this family a memorial keepsake blanket. That as you reflect upon Sophia's life in the days to come, that we will never forget her. She will always be a part of our hearts and everything that we do as a family. She will always be there in our hearts. It is our prayer to bless now and always.
In the name of Jesus, we pray.